My name is Sally Hawkins, and you might remember me from The Shape of Water, where I recently played Eliza, a mute woman who fell in love with an alien. Or rather, a really tall, glowing, amphibian-like man with beautiful scales and bulging eyes and wondrous healing powers. We never spoke a word out loud, but he sure did speak my language. Definitely a man of mystery. We all love an eccentric creature we can't quite figure out, right? As a professional actress, I take my job very seriously, and I wanted to get inside the mind of Miss Eliza, who first saw the creature as a curiosity, and then her equal, and finally, her fairy tale romance come true. And so I thought, all right, let's give it a go. Only it just kept going. And now I too am a wee bit infatuated and over what I'm not quite sure. But love, it's a splendid thing. But it's also unexplainable. And that's when we begin doing things we normally wouldn't have imagined doing before. Have you been there? No, we've all. We all do those weird things. Yeah. And so I wanted to embrace Eliza full throttle, with full sensation. And one night, while deep in the script, I began wondering, what would it be like to set someone free who was being held captive? Something suddenly came over me. Might have been the three margaritas. But I found myself Ubering to PetSmart and landing in the amphibian section. Looking into their green, bulging eyes and closing my eyes and listening to their beautiful songs. I could feel their sadness, their mass confusion, and their desire to live outside of these tiny glass walls and to stretch their athletic legs. And in that moment, I was Eliza in a covert operation. And within seconds, there were 30 froggies of all shapes and sizes dancing the way to freedom, 9 o'clock at night. Well, and then I had to release the crickets. And that's when all hell broke loose. But it was so thrilling, so full of activism. Speaking up for the underdog, frog in this case. And I don't care if I was a little arrested and banned from every PetSmart in California for the next 2 years. I was ready to be a movie hero, to rescue my mysterious love from his death sentence. Oh, this beautiful creature. So much more intelligent and loving than the nitwit hot-headed agent who transported him from his peaceful American refuge. Oh, strong. on a brighter note. Everyone likely knows by now that in life's end, the creature has sex. How else would it be in adult puberty? And so, right out of the gate, as a method actor, I want to experience pleasure in a whole new way. Totally different than normal. I had to show up on set with loving eyes for this creature, whatever it looked like. And when the director yelled, "Action!" I had to behave as though I really did want some action. I just didn't know who to turn to after my boyfriend broke up with me when I begged him to make passionate love to me in a body wrap of saran wrap and wearing green rubber uppermitts and doused in that tingly KY lubricant. I thought it would be quite dramatic and excellent character development. The life of an actor. Well, the other day, I got banned again. And this time, it was from every local restaurant called the Egg and I. You see, in the movie, Eliza and Amphibia Man make a special connection through her love and old fascination of boiled eggs. To be perfectly honest, I hated the bloody things until I fully embraced his character and love story. I had a sudden and completely unexpected when Harry met Sally moment. Right there in the lobby, I couldn't help it. I was just overwhelmed by this wafting tidal wave of nothing but heads. An older man nearly had a heart attack right there in the seat. But I know he appreciated my passion for the bullying. Now, even though I personally have a jail record and am banned from pet stores and eggy restaurants and a movie scene mall, I did learn something from the filming of this movie, Shape of Water. And that's, you never know where or when this magical connection may happen. And often between the most unlikely of characters. And you know, like some of Eliza's most favorite music, it doesn't always require spoken word, because it's a dance. It's a dance between souls and unique bodies. And there are loud times, and there are gentle times, and needed pauses. But you've got to keep dancing through life. Because sometimes your love song, though, it will be so beautiful and so powerful that it will drown out the background noise. And like water, you've got to let love flow. You can't.
can't grasp a hold and clench it, but you can flow with it and within it and through it. And just remember, like Eliza and her creature, with love, all things are possible.
Traci and Stickler. Traci and Stickler, Stickler.
I'd like to dedicate this to the wonderful Mexican director Del Toro and beautiful, beautiful creatures.